East Ohio's own, basking in Oscar gold tonight, a Chagrin Falls native accepted the Oscar for Best Animated Feature Film, Coco.
Well, our Jennifer Jordan went to Lee Unkrich's home of Chagrin Falls for reaction to the big win.
And the Oscar goes to Viva Latinoamerica, Coco!
One of Northeast Ohio's own taking center stage on Hollywood's biggest night.
We share this with our immensely talented cast and crew, as well as the executive teams at Disney and Pixar.
Thanks. Director Lee Unkrich of Chagrin Falls accepting the Oscars Sunday night for Best Animated Feature Film for Disney Pixar's Coco.
Me? Be back by lunch, mijo.
Love you, mama.
I am not like the rest of my family.
The critically acclaimed film is among Pixar's highest grossing films worldwide, which features the diversity of Mexican culture. The filmmaker's passion for the arts starting here in the hallways of Chagrin Falls High School. Kristen Wood, a member of his graduating class of 1985.
He was pretty quiet and kind of kept to himself, very artistic. In fact, he got in our class senior superlatives. He was awarded the most artistic award.
We have a CF-131, which references Lee's mother's license plate.
Chagrin alumni director Brian McKenna pointing out subliminal Chagrin Falls messages in the animated film Toy Story 3, another Oscar-winning movie for the filmmaker back in 2011. And check out his senior yearbook picture, where he may have predicted his fate. The caption underneath, "See you at the Academy Awards."
And he has now been there three times, winning twice, which is an unbelievable feat.
While he now calls L.A. home, he often comes back to where it all started. Last December, Lee hosted a screening of Coco at the Museum of Contemporary Art in University Circle, an event now taking on even greater meaning, with Coco now worthy of that little gold statue.
I think a lot of people think of Pixar movies or animations as for children, but they really, this movie in particular, is for everyone. So he really did something special with Coco.
Jennifer Jordan, Fox 8 News.
What a story there, y'all.